हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू तुंगल ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। लेट अस कंटिन्यू आवर डिस्कशन ऑन टू डायमेंशनल ज्योमेट्री ऑफ कोचिंग पार्ट, राइट। नेक्स्ट प्रॉब्लम, दैट इज 28th प्रॉब्लम। द पॉइंट्स 1, 3, 5, 1 आर टू अपोजिट वर्टेसिस ऑफ ए रेक्टेंगल इफ अदर टू वर्टेसिस लाई ऑन the line y is equal to 2x plus 3, then the value of c is, what they have given, two opposite vertices of a rectangle they have given, right? Two opposite means, if you take this point, that is 1, 3, opposite vertices means, if you take first point this one, then this is opposite side. If you take 1, 3 here, then opposite vertex is here, right? 1, 3 and 5, 1, these two points are opposite vertices of a rectangle and other two vertices lie on this straight line. Clearly it is of the form y equal to mx plus c, right? Clearly, other two vertices lies on the line y is equal to 2x plus c. And in a rectangle, diagonals intersect at midpoint. In square also they intersect at midpoint, in rectangle intersect at midpoint, in quadrilateral diagonals intersect at midpoint. Then what are the coordinates of this point? Clearly midpoint of this AC, right, B and D. Clearly this point is nothing but midpoint of AC. What are the coordinates? x1 plus x2 divided by 2, right? Means 6 divided by 2 is 3, 2. Now diagonals intersect at midpoint and clearly this diagonal passes through this point, means y is equal to 2x plus c passes through 3, 2, right? This line passes through the point 3, 2, means replace x value as 3, y value as 2, that's equal to 2 is equal to 2 into 3 plus c. After that 2 is equal to 6 plus c, then c value is -4, right? Because other diagonal is y equal to 2x plus c, its equation they have given. Clearly this diagonal passes through this point by using midpoint concept, because diagonals intersect at midpoint. By using that concept, write coordinates of this point. After that clearly this point lie on this line means passes through that point. So c value minus 4, that is second option. Next problem, next 29th question, previous one 28, next problem 29th one, right? First read the question, right? If 1, 2, 4, 3, 6, 4 are the midpoints of the sides BC, CA, AB of triangle ABC, then vertex A is, right? Clearly they have given midpoints of sides of triangle ABC, right? Suppose one triangle A, B and C, midpoints of sides of triangle ABC they have given. 1, 2 is midpoint of side BC. This is midpoint of side BC, 1, 2, right? Then 4, 3 is midpoint of CA or AC, right? 4, 3 and 6, 4. 6, 4, right? These three points are midpoints of sides of triangle ABC. Then find vertex A. We have shortcut formula. Vertex A is equal to, suppose D, E, F are the midpoints. Then vertex A equal to formula, the midpoint which is opposite to A, that subtract it, means E plus F, add these two, D is opposite to A, so minus D. This is formula for finding vertex A. If you want vertex B, then what is the formula? Which one is opposite to B? E. So minus E, add remaining two midpoints, right? Minus E, add these two, that is D plus F. If you want vertex C, then what is the formula? For C, which one is opposite? F is opposite, means minus F. Add remaining two midpoints, add these two, D plus E. But in this question, what they asked? Vertex A we want, right? We need this formula, right? Vertex A only we need. These two not necessary, right? That's equal. What is E? 4, 3. Plus what is F? 6, 4. Minus what are the coordinates of D? 1, 2. Now, consider X coordinates. 4 + 6 - 1. 4 + 6. That is 10 - 1, 9. Consider y coordinate. 3 + y coordinate 4, 7 - 2. That is 5. Vertex A is 9, 5. That is first option, right? This is shortcut formula. Suppose D, E, F are the midpoints of sides of triangle ABC, then A is equal to E plus F minus D. If you want A, for A, vertex A opposite is D, that subtract it. On simplification, it will be 9, 5, right? Next one. Next question, 31. The centroid and two vertices of a triangle are. Centroid of the triangle and two vertices they have given, right? Centroid and two vertices of a triangle are 4, -8, -9, 7 and 1, 4. Then area of the triangle is, right? Just draw a reference triangle. For understanding the question, just draw a triangle, right? Just take one triangle. What they have given? One centroid, means take this as a centroid. Centroid and two vertices. This is centroid. G they have given. What are the coordinates of G? 4 - 8. Centroid and two vertices. You can take these two vertices or these two vertices or any two vertices. One centroid and any two vertices they have given. I will take these two vertices. Assume that B and C are given, right? -9, 7 and 1, 4. And already we know formula. Area of triangle ABC equal to, area of triangle ABC is equal to required area A is equal to or area of triangle, ABC is equal to. Clearly, triangle ABC divided into three equal triangles. So it will be area of triangle ABC equal to 3 times area of the triangle BGC. 3 times area of triangle BGC, right? That's equal to 3 into. Already you know formula for area of the triangle. Whenever vertices are x1 comma y1, x2 comma y2 and x3 comma y3 is given. What is shortcut formula for finding area of the triangle? Already you know area of the triangle formula. x1 comma y1, x2 comma y2, x3 comma y3. Shortcut formula for finding area of the triangle is equal to 1 divided by 2 times determinant x1 minus x2 y1 minus y2 x1 minus x3 y1 minus y3. This is shortcut formula for finding area of the triangle whenever whose vertices are given. This is shortcut formula. While finding area of the triangle BGC, treat this as x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. Or else take this as x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. You can select any vertex as x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. There is no restriction to select x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3, right? You can select any one of the vertex as x1, y1, other two are x2, y2 and x3, y3, right? This is shortcut formula for finding area of the triangle. Area of the triangle 1 by 2 times determinant. I will treat this as x1, y1. No problem. You can select any one of the vertex as x1, y1, right? I will take this as x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3. Then x1 minus x2, x1 minus x2. 4 minus of minus 9 means it will be 13. Then y1 minus y2, y1 is minus 8, right? Minus 8 minus 7, it will be minus 15. Next, x1 minus x3, x1 minus x3, this is x1 y1, x2 y2, x3 y3, right? Then it will be 3. 4 minus 1, then minus 8 minus 4, it will be minus 12. Area of this triangle BGC equal to, right? Now already you know how to expand 2 by 2 determinant, right? 3 by 2 into product of diagonal elements minus non-diagonal elements. That is 13 into minus 12, minus of minus, it will be plus, 45, right? Product of diagonal elements, minus of minus, it will be plus. That's equal to 3 by 2 into 13 into 2. With negative sign, plus 45, right? Just simplify, then you get, after simplification, it will be 166.5 square units, right? And area never be negative, for that reason, consider positive value. On simplification, you may get negative value. After getting, just consider positive value. Why? Because area should not be negative. Just simplify, then you get 166.5 square units. That is second option, right? Next problem. Next, 32. Next problem, two vertices of a triangle are at 3, -1 and -1, 5. Its centroid is at the origin, then a third vertex is, right? Centroid and two vertices they have given, then find third vertex, that's all. Just figure out a triangle. It is triangle, assume that it is ABC. ABC, two vertices of a triangles are at these two points. I will take A, this is vertex A and vertex B. 3, -1, and what is vertex B? -1, 5, and vertex C we have to find. Take it as x3, y3. And one more condition they have given, right? Centroid is at origin. Z coordinates 0, 0 they have given. Centroid of the triangle is at origin. Means centroid of this triangle is origin. Then already you know the formula. Centroid Z is equal to, what is formula? x1 plus x2 plus x3 divided by 3 comma y1 plus y2 plus y3 divided by 3. This is formula for finding centroid of the triangle. In this case, two vertices and its centroid they have given. What is centroid? 0, 0. That's equal to. In this case, first point is x1, y1, second point is x2, y2, third point is x3, y3, right? Then 3, -1, plus x3 divided by 3, comma. -1, -1, plus 5, plus y3 divided by 3. Usual simplification. Then x plus 2 it is. X plus 2 divided by 3 is equal to, just equating corresponding elements. This term is equal to 0 and this term is also equal to 0. So x3 plus 2 divided by 3 equal to 0 and y3 plus 4 divided by 3 equal to 0. Then we get x3 is equal to minus 2 and y3 is equal to minus 4. Means our required vertex, third vertex is -2, -4, right? That is third option. Just by using centroid formula, centroid of the triangle is equal to centroid of the triangle whose vertices are x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3 is x1 plus x2 plus x3 divided by 3, y1 plus y2 plus y3 divided by 3. This is formula for centroid of the triangle. In this case, two vertices and its centroid they have given, then find third vertex. This is our third vertex, x3, y3. Clearly third option is the correct answer, right? Next, question number 33. The points a plus b, a minus b, 2a plus b, 2a minus b and a minus b, a plus b are the three consecutive vertices of a parallelogram, then a fourth vertex is. Missing vertex of the parallelogram. For this also we have one formula. Suppose A, B, C and D. In this case we need vertex D, fourth vertex we want, right? Missing vertex D is equal to, for vertex D, which one is opposite vertex? B, minus B, add remaining two. This is one of the shortcut formula. Vertex D is equal to, vertex D is equal to A minus B plus C. Which one is opposite? Vertex B is opposite. Vertex B is opposite to D. So minus B. Add remaining two vertices. If you want vertex C, then what we do? Add these two minus A. If you want, then vertex C is equal to formula. Suppose third vertex C is equal to, what is the formula? D plus B minus A. If you want vertex B, suppose second vertex, if you want B, for B which one is opposite? D, A plus B minus D, right? If you want vertex A, then what is A? Vertex A is equal to B plus D minus A. If you want A, then which one is opposite to A? Just subtract opposite vertex and add remaining two vertex. In this case, we want fourth vertex, that's all. D is equal to, for D, opposite vertex is B, so just minus, add remaining two vertices, that's all, right? Then first point is taken as A, that is A plus B comma A minus B minus vertex B. It is vertex A, vertex B and vertex C, right? Minus of 2A plus B comma 2A minus B plus C, vertex C, already they have given A minus B comma A plus B, right? Now usual simplification, A plus B minus 2A minus B, minus 2A minus B plus A minus B comma, similarly consider Y coordinate, right? A minus B minus A minus B minus 2A plus B plus A plus B, right? Now usual simplification, A plus B, here minus B is there, minus B is there, minus B plus B get cancelled, here minus 2A plus 2A get cancelled, what is remaining? Minus B. Then similarly simplify Y coordinate, minus B plus B, here plus 2A minus 2A get cancelled, remains with B. So fourth vertex is minus B comma plus B, that is third option. Missing vertex of the parallelogram formula. If you want vertex D, D is equal to, for D opposite vertex is B, that subtract opposite vertex and add remaining two vertex, right? This is required answer. Missing vertex of the triangle, this is also one of the shortcut formula for finding missing vertex of the parallelogram, right? Next, 34. Area of the quadrilateral. Already we have one shortcut formula for finding area of the quadrilateral. That quadrilateral may be a parallelogram or a rectangle or a square, right? Quadrilateral, right? First point is, suppose x1 comma y1, b of x2 comma y2, c of x3 comma y3, x3 comma y3 and d of x4 comma y4, right? Already we have a shortcut formula for finding area of the quadrilateral, right? What is shortcut formula for area of the quadrilateral? That's equal to 1 by 2 times determinant. Determinant x1 minus x3, x2 minus x4, y1 minus y3 and y2 minus y4, right? This is shortcut formula for finding area of the quadrilateral whose vertices are x1 comma y1, x2 comma y2 and x3 comma y3, x4 comma y4. Shortcut formula for finding area of the quadrilateral. Required area A is equal to, first of all, 1 by 2 times, what is the formula? X1 minus x3, x2 minus x4, y1 minus y3, y2 minus y4. This is shortcut formula for finding area of the quadrilateral. Take this point as x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3, and this point is x4, y4. Then just evaluate the determinant, right? That's equal to 1 by 2 times determinant. Determinant x1 minus x3. This is a x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. X1 minus x3, right? X1 minus x3. X1 minus 4. What is x3? Plus 5 means minus 9. Minus 4 minus 5. This is x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3, and x4, y4, right? And x2 minus x4. What is x2 here? 0. X2 minus x4 means plus 4 only, because 0 minus of minus, it will be plus. After that, y1 minus y3. Y1 minus y3 means 5 minus of minus plus, that is 10. Then y2 minus y4, y2 is 7, minus minus of minus, it will be plus, means 7 plus 2, that is 9. And already you know how to expand a 2 by 2 determinant, right? That's equal to 1 by 2 times minus 81, minus 81, minus 40. Lastly, you get 81, minus 81, minus 40. That's equal to minus 81 means minus 121 divided by 2, but area never negative. For that reason, consider positive value, because area of the triangle never be negative. Consider absolute value of this determinant. After simplification, you may get positive value or negative value, but suppose area is the, if suppose they ask area of the triangle or volume of the cone or area volume, such quantities are asked, then consider positive value, because area, length, volumes are not negative. So area of this quadrilateral is 121 divided by 2 square units, just by using shortcut formula. Next, a point on the x-axis which is equidistance from the point 7, 6 and 3, 4. Our required point lies on x-axis and which is equidistance from these two points. Then what is that point? Our required point is on x-axis means it is of the form x, 0. Any point on the x-axis whose y coordinate is 0, right? And take these two points as A and B, right? First point 7, 6 and second point B 3, 4, right? What they have given? PA distance equal to PB distance they have given, which are equidistances from, equidistances from given two points, right? Our required point lies on x-axis and which is equidistance from given two points, means what they have given, PA distance equal to PB distance they have given, right? Or PA square equal to PB square. Equidistance, for that PA square is equal to PB square. Then by using distance formula, what is PA square? Then x minus 7 whole square. And 0 minus 6 whole square means plus 36 only, because minus 6 whole square is plus 36. That's equal to, what is PB square? X minus 3 whole square. X minus 3 whole square, 0 minus 4 whole square, it will be 16, right? Now, just rearrangement. X square minus 14x. Just apply A minus B whole square formula. Then, plus 49 plus 36. That's equal to x square minus 6x, 2ab minus 2ab, plus b square 9 plus 16, right? Now, just rearrangement. Both the sides a square, x square term will be get cancelled. Then take this minus 6 into LHS. Minus 14x plus 6x. Remaining two terms send it to RHS. It will be 25 minus 49 minus 36, right? Then minus 8x equal to minus 14 plus 6 means minus 8. Then 25 minus plus 25 minus 49 means minus 24. Minus 24 minus 36. Means remains with minus 24 minus 36. So minus 8x equal to, if you add these two, 40, 60, it will be 60, right? Minus 60 both the sides, x equal to minus 60 divided by 8, minus 8, then x value, x equal to 4 2s are 4 15s, that is 15 divided by 2, means our required point is 15 by 2, y coordinate is clearly 0, why? Because it is on the x axis, so second option is the correct answer, right? PA distance equal to PB distance they have given, just by using given data, our required point is 15 by 2 comma 0, right? Next problem. Next problem, angle made by line segment joining these two points at origin is, right? Just use tan theta formula only. Two points they have given, 5 comma 2 is one point and 6 comma minus 15 is another point. Suppose this is P and it is Q and it is origin. The angle made by the line segment joining these two points at origin is, these all are pi by 6, pi by 4, pi by 2 and pi, not P. Make this P as pi. Pi, pi by 2, pi by 4, pi by 6. Just use tan theta formula, angle between two lines formula. First write slope of OP. Slope of OP is equal to M1 is equal to slope of line joining two points Y2 minus Y1 divided by X2 minus X1, that is 2 divided by 5. Then tell me what is slope of OP? Not OP, OQ. Slope of OQ is equal to M2, right? Minus 15 divided by 6, that's equal to 3 2s are 3 5s are, means minus pi by 2. Clearly product of slopes equal to minus 1. Clearly m1 into m2 is equal to minus 1 only. If you multiply these two, what you get? Minus 1. Product of these two is equal to minus 1, means OP is perpendicular to OQ only. OP is perpendicular to OQ means what is angle? Clearly this angle is 90 degree, theta, this is 90 degree. If you apply tan theta formula, then also you get 90 degree only, or else, or another method. Just use tan theta formula, angle between two lines formula, modulus of M2 minus M1 divided by 1 plus M1 into M2, right? That's equal. What is M2 here? Minus pi by 2, minus 2 divided by 5 divided by 1 plus 2 divided by 5 into minus 5 divided by 2. Clearly denominator becomes 0. Minus 5 by 2 minus 2 by 5 divided by 0 implies denominator 0 means infinity only. Tan theta is equal to infinity means what is theta value? When tan theta value is infinity, when theta is 90 degree, right? Theta theta is equal to 90 degree. Or else by using slope concept, directly we can say angle is 90 degree. Angle between OP and OQ is 90 degree, means angle at the origin is 90 degree. By using tan theta formula, we conclude theta is pi by 2. By using product of slopes equal to minus 1, for that reason theta is equal to pi by 2. You can use any one. Or else you have one more formula. Cos theta is equal to x1 y1 plus x2 y2 divided by square root of x1 square plus x2 square into square root of x2 square plus y2 square. You can use any one of the formula, then you get theta is equal to 90 degree, right? Next problem, question number 42. The points D, E, F are the midpoints of the sides BC, CA, AB of a triangle ABC respectively. If A, D and E, then find F, right? Just draw a triangle. Draw a triangle, right? This is one triangle ABC, right? A, B, C. Triangle ABC they have given. And D, E, F are the midpoints of BC. D is midpoint of BC. E is midpoint of CA. And F is midpoint of AB. They have given. In that A coordinates they have given minus 2 comma 3. D coordinates 1 comma minus 4. And E coordinates also they have given minus 5 comma 2. Then what are the coordinates of F? A is equal to what is formula? Suppose midpoints are given, then A is equal to formula. Vertex A is equal to, for vertex A, which one is opposite? D means minus D, add remaining 2. Add remaining 2 midpoints. Means E plus F minus D. But in this case, what they asked? Vertex F. Then just rearrangement. F is equal to, take these 2 into LHS. Then A minus E plus D, right? Vertex F equal to, this is basic one. By using standard result we can find F value. Then F is equal to, what are the coordinates of A? Minus 2 comma 3. Minus what are the coordinates of E? Minus 5 comma 2, right? Then what are the coordinates of D? 1 comma minus 4. This is basic formula. By using this basic formula we can find the coordinates of F also. Now minus 2 minus of minus plus 5 plus 1 means plus 5 plus 1 is plus 6 minus 2, that is 4. Then 3 minus 2 minus 4. 3 minus 2 minus 4 means minus 6. 3 minus 6 is minus 3, right? 4 comma minus 3 is our required answer, right? 4 comma minus 3, that is third option, right? Next problem. The area of the triangle formed by these three points in square units is, already you know shortcut formula, right? Area of the triangle A is equal to 1 by 2 times determinant x1 minus x2, x1 minus x3, determinant of x1 minus x2, x1 minus x3. Then y1 minus y2, y1 minus y3. Then first point is x1 y1, second point is x2 y2, and third point is x3 y3, right? That's equal 1 by 2 times determinant x1 minus x2, x1 minus x2. x1 minus x2 means clearly it will be 5, right? 2 minus of minus plus only. Then y1 minus y2, 5 minus 4, that is 1 only. Then 1 minus 3, x1 minus x3, 2 minus 7, that is minus 5. Then y1 minus y3, 5 minus of minus plus, it will be 6. That's equal to 1 by 2 times product of diagonal elements minus non-diagonal elements. 5, 6 is 30, minus of minus 5. That's equal to 35 divided by 2. 35 divided by 2 square units. Area of this triangle is 35 divided by 2 square units. Next problem. Clearly, if A, 45th question, if A is equal to minus 3 comma 4, B is equal to minus 1 comma minus 2, C equal to 5, 6, and D is equal to X minus 4 are vertices of a quadrilateral such that area of, make it, it is not D, triangle, 2 times triangle ACD. One of the quadrilateral they have given, right? Suppose it is A, B, C and D. It is one quadrilateral. But one more condition they have given. Area of the triangle ABD, ABD. Area of the triangle ABD is equal to 2 times area of the triangle ACD. Area of the triangle ACD. Right? What they have given? Area of the triangle. 45th question. Area of the triangle ABD is equal to 2 times area of the triangle ACD. Area of triangle ABD, right? ABD is equal to 2 times area of triangle ACD. While finding area of the triangle ABD, treat coordinates of A as x1, y1 and coordinates of B as x2, y2 and coordinates of D as x3, y3. While finding, treat this as one triangle. And while finding ACD triangle, area of ACD, x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. Then 1 by 2 times determinant. Just use shortcut formula. Or else write the coordinates. Minus 3, comma 4. Minus 1, comma minus 2. 5, comma 6. And x, comma minus 4. Now, while finding area of the triangle ABD, it is x1, y1, x2, y2, x3, y3. What is formula, shortcut formula? X1 minus x2, right? Minus 3 minus 1. Minus of minus, it will be plus, means it is minus 2. X1 minus x2. Then next row element, x1 minus x3, 1 minus 3. While finding ABD, this is x3, y3. x1 minus x3. What is x1? Minus 3 is x1 and x is x3. That is minus 3 minus x. Similarly, y1 minus y2, right? 4 minus of minus 2 is plus. So it will be 6. Then y1 minus y3. y1 minus y3 means minus of minus plus. It will be 8. That's equal to 2 into area of the triangle formula, 1 by 2 times determinant. While finding area of the triangle ACD, ACD, treat x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3, right? ACD, x1 minus x2, it will be minus 8. 1 minus 2 and 1 minus 3. While finding ACD, this is x1 y1, x2 y2, and x3 y3, right? Then x1 minus x3, that is minus 3 minus x. Similarly, y coordinate, y1 minus y2, it will be minus 2, right? y1 minus y2, 4 minus 6 is minus 2. Then y1 minus of minus, it will be plus 8 only. Now, both the sides 1 by 2 will be get cancelled. After that, usual simplification. Product of diagonal elements minus 16 minus minus into minus plus 3 plus x into 6, that's equal to 2 times product of diagonal elements minus 64 minus of 2 into 3 plus x. Product of diagonal elements minus non-diagonal. Now usual simplification, right? Minus 16 plus 18 plus 6x, right? Usual multiplication, that's equal to 2 into minus 64 minus 6 minus 6 minus 2x. Now just rearrangement means 2 plus 6x equal to usual multiplication, this is 70. 70 into 2 means 140. Minus 140 minus into 2 means minus 4x. Just rearrangement. Take this term into LHS, then it will be 142. That's equal to minus minus, send it to RHS, then minus 10x. Then x equal to minus 142 divided by 10. Minus 2, minus 6, minus 70, minus 70 into 2 is 140, minus 4x, right? Here 6, 3 is 18, minus 16, 6x. If you send this 6x, then minus 10x. That's equal to, while simplifying something went wrong, just correct it, right? Can you correct it? Yes, just correct this problem. Area of the triangle ABD is equal to 2 times area of the triangle ACD, they have given. Just simplify, right? Next, 47th question. For collinearity, just use slope concept, right? For collinearity, just use slope concept. Take this point as A, this is B and C. Just take slope of AB is equal to slope of BC. Why? Because given points are collinear. For easier simplification, just take slope concept. Slope of AB is equal to slope of BC, right? Slope of AB is equal to slope of BC. Why? Because these three points are collinear. Then what is A square plus B square plus C square? Then slope of AB is equal to, while finding slope of AB, this point is x1 y1 and it is x2 y2, c minus b divided by b minus a, that's equal to slope of BC. While finding BC, this is x1 y1 x2 y2, a minus c divided by c minus b, right? Just cross multiplication, c minus b whole square is equal to a minus c into b minus a. Usual multiplication, apply a minus b whole square, a square plus b square minus 2ab, that's equal to ab minus a square minus bc minus ca, right? Take this a square term into LHS, then it will be a square plus b square plus c square. Remaining term send it to RHS. Here minus bc is there, send it to RHS. It becomes plus bc, right? Plus 2bc minus bc means clearly bc only, right? Send it to RHS. It will be b into c only. Sorry, here minus ca is there. Minus c into it will be plus minus bc means ab plus bc plus ca. AB plus BC plus CA. A square plus B square plus C square is equal to AB plus BC plus CA. That is second option, right? Next problem. Question number 50. A circle with center at 3 comma minus 4 touches x axis. Just draw a circle in the given circumstances, right? Consider 2D plane, it is x axis and y axis. This is the center of the circle and clearly this point is in fourth quadrant, right? 3 comma minus 4, x coordinate positive and y coordinate negative means fourth quadrant, and it is center of the circle and it touches x axis, means our required circle touches x axis. Then what is its radius? 3 comma minus 4 they have given. We need to find radius of the circle. This distance between x axis and this point is center radius. Clearly it touches x axis means vertical distance is radius only, horizontal distance. Vertical distance and horizontal distance, any point in a plane. For example, suppose point x comma y is there, then vertical distance is y coordinate, horizontal distance is x coordinate. Then what is this distance? This distance is nothing but modulus of y coordinate, because this is y coordinate of that point. Vertical distance means y coordinate of that point, and consider absolute value means positive value, because distance never be radius means it is positive only. Modulus of y coordinate, this length is modulus of y coordinate means 4 units. Y coordinate with consider positive value, why? Because radius means it is length, length never be negative. For that reason it is 4 units. Always y coordinate. Y coordinate, but consider positive value if it is not positive. Why? Because radius is positive. 4 units. Next question. A of minus 1 comma 3 and B of 1 comma minus 1 and C of 5 comma 1 are the vertices of a triangle ABC. Then the length of the median through vertex A is. Clearly all the vertices are given, right? Consider one triangle ABC. ABC. Vertex A is minus 1 comma 3, vertex B is 1 comma minus 1, and vertex C is 5 comma 1. Then find the length of the median, length of the median through vertex A. We need to find this length AD length, length of the median. For that just consider small ABC values. Side length is taken as small ABC. The side which is opposite to vertex A, its length is taken as small a. The side which is opposite to B, its length is taken as small b. The side which is opposite to vertex C is taken as small c units. Means small ABC are side lengths. Then tell me what is AB? AB by using distance formula, right? AB is nothing but small c. small c equal to square root of by using distance formula y2 minus y1 whole square minus 1 minus 3 means minus 4 whole square is plus 16 1 minus of minus plus that is 2 1 minus of minus plus 2 whole square means it is 4 lastly we get root 20 units right after that AB then BC BC length is nothing but small a unit small a is equal to square root of by using distance formula 4 because minus 1 minus of minus plus 2 whole square is 4 then 5 minus 1 whole square that is 16 that's also equal to root 20 after that CA distance between two point formula CA is nothing but small b small abc are side lengths right CA is equal to CA 3 minus 1 2 whole square is 4 right then minus minus 1 minus 5 whole square means 36 that's equal to root 40 now we get small abc values then already you know formula length of the median through vertex a is equal to length of the median through vertex a is equal to length of the median through vertex a is equal to length of the median through vertex a equal to we have one shortcut formula 1 by 2 times square root of through vertex a means minus a square right then 2 into b square plus c square now just simplify already you have small a small b and small c values that's equal to 1 by 2 times square root of 2 into what is b square b square b square is 40 right small b square plus c square is plus 20 c square value 20 minus what is a square is 20 that's equal to 1 by 2 times square root of it will be 60 into 2 that is 120 120 minus 20 that's equal to 1 by 2 into square root of 100 that's equal to 1 by 2 into 10 that's equal to 5 units length of the median through vertex a is 5 units just find all the side lengths after that use the formula length of the median through vertex a is equal to 1 by 2 times through vertex a means minus a square through vertex b means minus b square through vertex c means minus c square that is 5 units with this problem I will stop today's class and remaining all the problems you have to solve if you have any doubt just ask in the group tomorrow I will start straight lines coaching part right thank you